Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection, because perfection doesn't exist. Let's take a look at some new skincare beauty launches. It's just constant. It's constant, constant, constant. Some of it's good, some of it's bad, and we're gonna look at a good mixture of launches today. Starting with a product I've been using for a good few weeks pre-launch and the sponsor of today's video. That is Glow Recipe and their new product, the Cloudberry Bright Essence Toner. Oh my God. This is kind of like a multitasking treatment stage. You know, I've said in the past before that there's a very fine line nowadays between toner, essence, and serum. And this is such a good example of that multitasking 2-in-1, 3-in-1 product. The main benefits of the essence toner is everything you would expect from your toner stage up to your serum stage. So you've got your hydration, your brightening, your evening of skin tone, hydration of the toner, the fermented ingredients of an essence, and then the actives of a serum, all whilst prepping your skin for your next steps. So what is Cloudberry? So Cloudberry kind of looks like a yellow raspberry, like it's really cute. So Cloudberry is rich in antioxidants, vitamin C and E, which they fermented into the product to allow for better absorption of ingredients, helping with better hydration, efficacy of the other ingredients in here, allowing for those ingredients to help your skin look brighter, more even, providing that deeper hydration. One of those ingredients being coenzyme Q10. So coenzyme Q10 is an antioxidant, does all the amazing things antioxidants do, helps fight free radical damage, helping maintain that collagen and elastin production. But also what it's going to do is work alongside the other ingredients found in Cloudberry, being that vitamin C and vitamin E. Even all those antioxidants are a real good boost for your skin. Also making it very good for easily sensitized skin. If you don't like vitamin C on the skin, you'll love this. You will not notice there's vitamin C in it. Coenzyme Q10 is naturally found within our body. And like collagen and elastin, it's something that just kind of depletes as we age. Like everything. So it's a great ingredient to start using alongside your retinols, peptides, to help with that collagen, elastin back in the skin, help refirm the skin. So see this as a prevention stage. This isn't something you have to use once you start seeing fine lines. This is something you should be using in your 20s, leading up to when you know you're gonna start getting fine lines and stuff. It's prevention and maintenance stage. The 5% glycerin in this toner essence made a huge difference. We all love glycerin. We're all falling in love with glycerin as one of the better humectants over things like hyaluronic acid. That's just really keeping my skin hydrated throughout the colder months. And then you team that with fermented rice water, which you typically find fermented ingredients in essences. And not only does the fermented rice water help give your skin this more luminous complexion, but fermented rice water is especially a staple in a lot of K-beauty for helping to soothe the skin as well. Add fermentation into that process, allowing the ingredients to be better absorbed into the skin. Fermented ingredients for me of any kind in an essence is a must have. You must have it. And yeah, it just helps brighten the skin. To use, this is such a nice watery toner. This is what you'd expect a toner to feel like. In the packaging, it almost looks like a little bit of like a watery jelly, but the moment you pump it out into your hand, again, the pump is here to kind of keep all the ingredients inside fresh. And the moment you pump it into your hand, it then kind of turns into a more liquidy toner. Then when you put it on your skin, it almost just feels like water on the skin. So very different to their watermelon toner, because once this hits the skin, it just kind of sinks in. You feel like your skin's just had like a little drink of something. And whilst this does have a slight smell to it, it's very refreshing, but it's almost citrusy without being lemony and bleachy. The smell's citrusy sweet. So where would you even put this in your routine? It's a multitasker. You can just use it in the toner stage, toner essence stage, then use whatever you use alongside it. I personally, when trialing products, tend to cut my routine right back. So I took this away to Copenhagen with me. I was away in Manchester for a bit and I used it prior as well. But this was the only step I took between a cleanser and a moisturizer, because this is the toner, essence and serum. That's all I needed for that week that I was away. I was packing light. So if you are looking for a bit of a multitasker, or you just want something new that's gonna do pretty much everything in the sense of hydrate your skin, keep it hydrated, give you that glow that like a vitamin C does, the antioxidants. You want to help prevent fine lines and wrinkles. You want even skin tone. This is a great multitasker to go for. If you are looking to strip back your routine, or you just wanted to add that extra something into the steps of your routine, this is an amazing product to go for. Here in the UK, you could buy this at Cult Beauty. I will, of course, link it in the description down below. America, Glow Recipe. Thank you to Glow Recipe recipe for sponsoring this segment of today's video. Links in the description box down below. Love it. Let's take a look at another product. KFC Spain have launched a fragrance. It looks like a piece of chicken, and this will have the aroma of the original recipe herb and spice, combined with geranium, mandarin, pink pepper, and bergamot to give a fresh yet natural feel. I'm not gonna lie, if you think about herbs and spices mixed with bergamot, all those like deeper kind of scents, I don't think this is gonna smell bad. I don't think they're launching it to smell like the inside of a family bucket. They did have some candles, I think it was KFC, that did smell exactly like fried chicken that I really, really wanted. I believe they had like ketchup scent, gravy. I love their gravy so, so much. I can't be the only person who takes the skins off the chicken and dips it into the gravy and eats that separate. People must do that, right? You do that. So first of all, it sounds absolutely crazy, but when I think of the smells, I think this could be potentially really, really nice. I'm not gonna be able to get my hands on this. It's in Spain. I'm not going to Spain anytime soon. I don't know how to shop on Spanish internet, and I very much doubt they're gonna deliver to the UK. Sounds like it's gonna smell good. It could potentially smell good. Horrific packaging. Horrific packaging, like awful. The advert's funny though, they kind of done it like typical fragrance advert, I guess, kind of taking the piss. So yeah, I'm not gonna get it, but I don't think it's gonna be as bad as it looks or sounds. Peach and Lily have launched two new products, Rescue Party Barrier Comfort Cream and Rescue Party Barrier Restore Serum. I really like Peach and Lily's products. I feel like they have a nice small kind of capsule collection at the moment. Obviously, their library will grow, but I do feel like they really take their time to figure out what it is that consumers want and also what kind of products are needed within the space as well. So these products have 5 different ceramides and good fats help replenish your skin barrier, 0.8% colloidal oatmeal to relieve signs of irritation, Korean star botanicals like heartleaf and mugwort, and panthenol visibly quell inflammation. Quell, that's a nice word I haven't heard for a while. Hyaluronic acid and squalane restore lost moisture, importantly and uniquely stay ahead of the calcium curve with a proprietary calcium complex and visibly restore your skin barrier. What is the calcium curve? Did you know our skin barrier needs calcium? No. Our skin has literal calcium curve, aka epidermal calcium gradient. Does anybody else know this? With calcium ions in a bell-shaped distribution, healthy levels are linked to a healthier skin barrier. Depleted levels equals a weak barrier. Our calcium complex delivers calcium deep into skin and visibly restores the barrier. I did not know that. I did not know that. Listen, I love my Ordinary Barrier Soothing Support Serum, but I do trust Peach and Lily enough to want to try this serum. It actually looks really, really good. Okay, so the serum is $47 and the cream is also $43. Peach and Lily are kind of a little bit up there in price range. I will always want to try their products because of that vitamin C serum they did that literally helped with a huge irritated scar that I had picked because of a spot kind of thing. It just helped get rid of that dark spot, that post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation of redness so quickly that I will always pay a bit more money for Peach and Lily because I know their products work for me. But let me know what you think. Let me know what you think down below. This does sound like a unique take on a barrier support product, which are readily available everywhere, but this does sound like a more unique take that I'm interested in. I mean, so far so good with these new launches, I feel. Another month, another Rhode lip launch. Listen, say what you want about the brand, say what you want about Hailey Bieber, but don't attack her in my comments. I don't care what people think of Hailey Bieber. Just gonna say I don't care. This isn't a new product, I've just missed this one. This is like a sparkly tinted lip treatment, birthday candy, cute limited edition. As I was saying, say what you want about the brand or the person behind the brand. They have some of the best, if not the best, nearly lip products on the market. Their lip products are so good. So, so good. The main thing being peptides in here, which is like the whole range, but this lip balm is really, really good at kind of helping lock in that moisture, help smoothing out those lips. Do I want glittery lips? No, but I understand that other people will. I think this is a fun 90s throwback. Not going to spend too much time on this one because we talked about the lip products to death. Interesting, nice, limited editions are fun. Ooh, Zara Hair have just launched some new stuff. They have teamed up with Guido Palu for a collection that will include 2 hair products. All sold as a set, costing $49.90. They have a Give Me Glitter Hair Makeup Spray, which is a hair gold glitter mist, a Give Me Gold Hair Makeup Gel, a metallic gold water-based styling gel, a styling comb, and bobby pins. This is cute if you want a very particular look. Staff party if you want to go in with some, like, curls and some waves. You know, like, literal pin curls with metallic hair. It's a very specific look that they're going for here. I personally can't imagine turning up somewhere with gold hair. And, like, glitter spray. But, you know, each to their own. I think it's kind of pricey at $50 almost for probably, like, a one-off use. Because how many times are you gonna go somewhere with glittery hair or metallic hair? Probably never. The pins look fine and the cone looks okay, but would I pay $50 for some party spray? Absolutely not. Zara are usually a little bit more budget. Are they? No, they're not. Sorry, I'm thinking of like their fragrance dupes. It's a cute collaboration. I think it's fun. But for me, this is a very particular look that I don't see a lot of people doing ever, even at parties and stuff. Maybe fun for kids? I don't know. I do believe this is Zara's first venture into hair products, which is exciting. I say this, I don't really shop at Zara anymore. They do some really good fragrances, but for me, like, I don't fit into their clothes. Even their extra, extra large, I don't know what the fuck they're doing with their sizing, but I can't navigate their clothes sizing. But yeah, not for me. I'm not a metallic hair glitter spray kind of gal. SKKN By Kim are launching minis of their products, which I'm guessing are still extortionate. If you saw my review of this brand, my kind of final outcome was that the products are fine. The eye cream was really, really good. Like, I love the eye cream. But the products were fine, but I wouldn't pay that much for them. Their refills are pointless. So they've released a mini face duo set, which includes their exfoliant and their daily skin nourishment, which is one of the moisturizers. Two minis at £48. I mean, this is okay if you want to try out their products, if you don't mind spending nearly 50 quid on two minis. Maybe a stocking filler for somebody, and then that's it. Just those two rolling around in the stocking. I would love if they did the mini or the eye cream because I would use that eye cream up. Yeah, as I mentioned, I understand luxury. I understand the want to buy luxury skincare and have a luxurious experience. But there are brands that I feel like don't really fit that bill. And I feel like SKKN By Kim is one of them. I know she's all about luxury fashion and stuff, but I don't associate her with luxury. I don't know about other people. She looks amazing, incredible in everything she does. But I think her audience are more commercial. And I feel like this should have been like mid-luxury, you know, like maybe like 50 quid being the most expensive thing. I mean, if you want to try them, fork out 50 quid for these two. The exfoliant wasn't one of my favorites at all. The cream also wasn't a favorite. They were just fine. But yeah, give it a go if you want to. One of my favorite brands, Saltair, have just launched lip products. They say that these are lip oil balms and they're available in clear and four sheer buildable shades. Dragon fruit, acai, toasted, and cocoa. I struggle with that word so much, I don't know why. All featuring a coconut vanilla flavor. Nice. So Saltair is from the same kind of like hub as Naturium. So I wonder how similar their lip products are going to be. None of the products are similar between Saltair, Naturium, Prequel, Make, Fleur. Like none of them are similar. Well, no, there's a few similarities. But these do look a little bit more pigmented than the Naturiums, which have a nice kind of like light tint. So I do want to try them. They say that they have a slippy, cushiony balm filter. Shea butter, coconut oil, meru, plant-derived esters. This oil balm nourishes and hydrates dry lips with a subtle sheen. I like the look of that. I really like the look of that. They're $9 each, which isn't bad at all. Can you buy the whole set? No. $9 each. Yeah, I'd pay for that. That looks good. That looks really nice. Just popping in here, unedited. Well, I'm going to edit this. Her dinner's in an hour's time. But she will wait here for that full hour for her dinner. Rare Beauty have just announced they are doing body care. By the sounds of it, they have a hydrating body mist, a body cream, a hand cream, and an aromatherapy pen, which I'm guessing is going to be lavender or something like that. They haven't said much more about it, and I've just kind of got to film this and put it out because I'm going to London. I will buy it. I'm going to be buying it. I trust Rare Beauty. I trust that Selena Gomez is so involved in the brand. I know everybody loves the makeup. The quality is amazing. So yes, I will be buying the Rare Beauty stuff. The packaging looks really good, really unique. I love that hand cream packaging as well. I do wonder what it smells like. They've not released a ton of details yet.
So we'll see.
Oh my God, and then that's it. Wow, that was quick. You know what? I'm interested in a lot of these. I'm very interested in a lot of these. I feel like a lot of them I would use on a daily basis. Well, most of them. And a good few interesting launches. I really hope, this is the last one of these videos I'm going to be doing before the end of the year. So I do hope in the next year we see a bit more variation with product launches. Maybe you're slowing down of brands constantly pumping out new products because we only need so much skincare, you know? Let me know what you think about these launches in the comments down below. And thank you again to Glow Recipe for sponsoring a segment of today's video. Oh, I love it. It's here. It's here because I use it all the time. Give it a go. Let me know what you think. If you love Glow Recipe, you're going to love it, I promise you. You could watch some more product reviews here, some general light entertainment here, and I'll see you over there.